Did you know that your vehicle may be equipped with a convenient feature that can help make maneuvering a trailer in reverse easy? It's called Pro Trailer Backup Assist, and there are a few steps you'll need to do first in order to use it. Let me explain. Before you begin, you'll need a few things to help with the setup. Your supplied Quick Start Setup Guide with measurement card, a tape measure, a pencil, an assistant to help out if needed, as well as the checkered sticker that comes with your guide. I'll tell you about that later. First, you'll need to connect your vehicle to your trailer on a level surface. For best results, it is recommended to use a drawbar with the appropriate rise or drop to position your trailer level to the ground. Then, line up the vehicle and trailer by pulling forward so they're in line with one another. Second, from inside the vehicle, to begin programming, press the center of the Pro Trailer Backup Assist button located to the right of the steering wheel, here. Use the arrows on the steering wheel and select Add Trailer and press OK. Then, using the up and down and left and right arrows of the five-way controls, spell out the name of the trailer, using the right arrow to advance to the next letter. To delete a letter, press the up and down arrow key until you see a blank space. Press OK once finished. Next, select the type of brake system for your trailer. Electric surge is the default. Then press OK. Now, select the desired brake effort for your trailer. Low is the recommended setting for most trailers, while medium or high will apply the brakes quicker, if you prefer, which is perfect if you have a larger, heavier trailer, for instance. The system may prompt you to set up the trailer blind spot information system, or BLIS. Select No at this time. You'll then get a message asking if you want to continue to Trailer Backup Assist setup. Select Yes to confirm. A prompt will direct you to straighten the trailer to continue setup. You'll then get another message directing you to put the vehicle in park and to place the Pro Trailer Backup Assist sticker on your trailer tongue. Now I'm going to tell you how to place the checkered sticker I just mentioned. The sticker acts as a target that the Pro Trailer Backup Assist feature and rear view camera use to track which direction the trailer is moving. Take the checkered sticker and measurement card with you to the rear of the vehicle. You'll want to place the sticker within 7 to 20 inches from the center of the trailer hitch ball. You'll also need to make sure to place the sticker on a flat, horizontal surface that is visible by the rear view camera. This is where an assistant would be helpful. Once the sticker is in place, you'll need to use your tape measure to get and record several measurements. First, measure the horizontal distance from the license plate to the center of the hitch ball and write it down. Next, measure the horizontal distance from the center of the hitch ball to the center of the sticker and the distance from the rearview camera to the center of the sticker. Keep in mind, the location is not dependent on a straight or A-frame type trailer, but based on where a surface is available that meets the requirements. And finally, the horizontal distance from the tailgate to the center of the trailer axle, if it's a single axle trailer. If the trailer has two or more axles, measure to the center point between both axles. Okay, now I'll tell you how to input the measurements into the system's information display. To input the measurements you recorded outside the vehicle, use the up and down arrows on the five-way control on the left side of the steering wheel to increase or decrease the numbers as needed. Then press OK to confirm each measurement and to move on to the next measurement. Once you've added the last measurement, the information display will show you all of the entered measurements. If correct, select Confirm and hit OK. Once you confirm the measurements, the system will automatically search for the sticker and highlight it with a red circle. A message will then ask you if the sticker is circled. If it is, select Yes to confirm. You'll get a confirmation message letting you know setup is complete and measurements are saved. If you do not see the sticker circled, select No. Make sure the measurements are correct and that the trailer and vehicle are positioned straight. Finally, you'll need to drive the vehicle straight forward between 4 and 24 miles per hour as directed until you get a message confirming calibration is complete. Any questions? Go to owner.ford.com.